Geno Smith, always ready.
Do these guys ever stop?
No, I don't think so. You know, that's how you run, the hurry-up offense.
Well, we told you he was a perfectionist. Never wants to stop.
In that opening 15 minutes, combined offense, 280 yards, 28 points between Baylor and West Virginia. Florence stands, now rolls out of the pocket, chased. Stutter steps, oh, he took his shot in the numbers inside the 30-yard line. Petros, a lot of offense, a lot of hard hitting, some injuries piling up, too, in that opening quarter.
Unbelievable pace right now. And, guys, you talk about both these quarterbacks. They really just want to sit back there and distribute to all these wonderful athletes you see around them. Joel, you hit on that theme earlier. This is the Big 12 Conference.
Florence rides his back, now throws it far side, and it's out of bounds off Terrence Williams. Could not bring it down in bounds. And Josh, this, Francis, the buck.
This is one of those opportunities. You sense it from the crowd. It's third and 11. It's a tie game, and it's an extremely important down. They've got to get off the field here.
Boy, rare substitution for that West Virginia defense. Baylor 2 for 2 on third down tries. They put some fresh legs on the field. Joe DeForest, the West Virginia defensive coordinator. Now this crowd is alive. Just got the snap away. Florence stands, throws it high. Ball on the hands of Sampson. Move the chains to the 40-yard line. Lanier Sampson with the reception. And a first down for Baylor.
What a throw from Nick Florence. Touch pass all the way, far sidelines, converts it for Baylor.
26-yard pickup. Glasgow Martin is off the right side. And Petros, understand, Jared Salubi also has been shaken up. They've already lost one of their fine defensive backs in Dimitri Goodson.
Salubi's a senior, guys. He's been running the ball very well in this game. But he came off with the shoulder. They're checking him out right now.
Second down after a pickup of 5. Quick hitter near side, Levi Norwood. Joe, I can't imagine trying to, why you wouldn't want to play for Baylor. If you're a wide receiver, an inside receiver, a slot back, a running back, you know you're going to get the football.
How about this? Terrence Garvin blitzing, hits Nick Florence in the back late, draws the personal foul, roughing the passer. Now Baylor's going to be down inside the 15-yard line. That's not a smart play from Terrence Garvin. Sometimes the offenses go so fast, the defensive players get frustrated that they can't make a play. And when the opportunity presents itself, they go a step too far.
First and 10 inside the 15-yard line. Martin lowers his shoulders, and Will Clark makes the initial hit, number 98 for the Mountaineers. A pickup of 2, second down long. Clark stands 6'7", goes 271 out of Pittsburgh. Martin again, met at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a half a yard, Isaiah Bruce and company. Put the hit on Martin. If Salubi can't come back, Joel, Martin's going to have to take a load in that backfield.
Another huge down. Third down for West Virginia. Just forcing the opposition to attempt a field goal is a defensive success for them. They've got the chance right here.
Blitz. Florence taken down. That brings up fourth down. Terrence Garvin, who was just whistled for that late hit, came strong and put the pressure on Nick Florence.
Three straight plays, they ran the exact same pressure concept. It's a zone pressure, the Sam and outside linebacker to the wide side of the field, blitzing, the line slanting, Baylor trying to get outside the pocket. The only hard part with that outside blitzer, Craig, it's very difficult to get outside that contained player. A great call by defensive coordinator Joe DeForest from West Virginia.
Aaron Jones, a 33-yard attempt, and the kick is up and no good. Jones misses from 33. all the emotions of Big 12 football. Baylor on the road. 25th ranked West Virginia, number 9 in the country, making their Big 12 conference football debut. And it's homecoming. We're tied at 14 early in the second quarter here in Morgantown. Baylor says one thing, welcome to the Big 12. Geno Smith, the pitch, Austin can't find the edge. Stutter steps, and he'll get back to the line of scrimmage at the 20-yard line. Surrounded by a host of Baylor Bears.
The little touch pass. It's like a basketball play to Tavon Austin, but the pursuit from Baylor, how about all those white hats around the ball? Pursuing the ball is paramount when you got a fast, quick twitch guy like Tavon Austin. Baylor does a nice job on that last play.
Geno Smith, shotgun, whistles will stop play.
Before the snap, false start, offense number 57. 5-yard penalty, second down.
That's Richie Smith, our referee today. Flags on Jeff Braun, the right guard, senior. To this front line of West Virginia, he goes 316. Joe Mattson, the senior, 305. Josh Jenkins, the left guard, 303. They can move a mountain. 11 minutes to play in the half. Smith in the pocket, comfortable throw. It's short underneath. Only a pickup of 3 on the hands of Austin.
I like they got half of that back. You know, second and 15, you come in, get about an 8-yard completion to your slot guy. Now it's a more manageable third down, 3rd and 7. Look for Tavon Austin here. He's probably going to get double teamed, which might leave this wide receiver wide open.
5 wide receivers. Smith, the long snap count. Sets his feet, throws short, off his hands, incomplete. And Baylor, a little press coverage, Joel, and that would have been short of the first down. Ivan McCartney, the ball went through his hands, and here's a rare punt.
Baylor gets off the field. Geno Smith trying to complete that ball into the short side of the field. That's a difficult proposition because there's just less space. When you work to the wide side where your 3 wide receivers are, you have more space and opportunities to throw that ball in the vulnerabilities of the defense.
Corey Smith will punt inside his own 10-yard line. Norwood finds a seam, 50, watch out, 40. Norwood, 30. Norwood inside the 25-yard line. Forty-five yard return.
And setting up that high-powered offense inside the 25-yard line. Baylor with the ball at the 23-yard line. Tie game, 14-14.
A lot of push-ups in Morgantown.
I was say, he better pace himself. The Mountaineer better pace himself today.
14 all. 10:03 to play here in quarter number 2. Great return. Sets up Baylor, 1st and 10 at the 23-yard line. Florence in the gun. Tevin Reese, the motion man. Florence in traffic, nearly had it intercepted down inside the 5. Reese was the intended receiver, but good pressure up front by West Virginia.
And this is why Nick Florence had to get rid of the ball before he wanted to. He could feel that pressure coming from the middle of the pocket. That was George Wright that came in, a senior from Miami, and applied the pressure to Nick Florence.
2nd down, 10. Lake Seastrom in the backfield. He'll get the carry. Tries to cut it back. You know what? That was a great fake by the quarterback on option. He took that ball right out of the belly of Seastrom on a keeper, and he picks up maybe 2. That brings up 3rd down.
The fact that they don't have Jared Salubi in the game has really hurt them because their run game was really helping them on 1st and 2nd down. Now another 3rd and long. You got 3rd and 6 for Baylor.
Florence runs up as they try to audible out of this play. I'll tell you, the play clock's running out. Down to three, just got the snap away. Florence stands, throws, far side, pitch and catch, caught, Williams. And he's out of bounds inside the 5 yard line at the two.
Pat Miller, the corner on the top of your screen, or the top of the formation, gave way too much cushion for third and six. Didn't understand where the sticks were, and that's where Terrence Williams stops, gives his chest to the quarterback, Nick Florence, easy conversion.
Martin, touchdown Baylor. Glasgow Martin, second touchdown run in this first half from 7 and now from 2 yards out.
Look at him find the hole low near the ground. Gets over the goal line. Baylor, their third touchdown of the day, second for Martin.
Aaron Jones with the point after. He's been busy, 3 for 3. When we come back from break, the Fox College Saturday studio will have a preview of the Pizza Hut halftime report. Stay tuned.
After not getting points on their previous series.
Aaron Jones, line drive kick, takes a wicked hop. Right around the 6 yard line, and Tavon Austin smartly lets just that ball fly away.
Petros Baylor on the last series stopped that jet sweep to Tavon Austin. If they can do that, as well as run to the outside and stop those bubble screens on first down, they're going to be in good shape.
It's about taking away what's on the perimeter and a first down play for West Virginia, because Sean Alston, their big back, is not playing, is really those perimeter plays. They're kind of like in place of a run game. Baylor's done a good job of pursuing and getting over there and stopping it. If they do that, they're looking good defensively.
Bowie lines up behind Geno Smith. Play action, one pump, sets up the screen. Oh, tough catch, but he brings it down. And that's Dustin Garrison, number 29, with a nice pickup. Let's go back to Los Angeles. A game break.
It's 10-10, back to you.
All right, thank you, Patrick. Here it's 21-14, big first down run by Garrison as he rumbles up to the 37-yard line.
There's that first down, and now watch the rhythm, the confidence for West Virginia. Geno Smith gets the play to the offensive line, and here they go.
From the gun. Looks one way, throws near side. Did he have a foot down? Yes, at the 47. J.D. Woods, what a half he's had. Senior out of Naples, Florida.
Just such a good job by Geno Smith. Watch him looking left and flips all the way to the right side of the formation and then delivers the ball right where he needs to. Maybe a little too far outside, but his wide receiver is able to get a foot down for the completion. Complete command of the offense for Geno Smith.
Second down short. Fly it out to Alston. He'll dance for the first down. Spins out of a tackle. Past midfield to the 48-yard line. Well, what an explosive player. Averages 115 yards, 11 receptions a game.
He's the special teams player of the year last year in the Big East Conference, and you see why. So shifty and quick in space.
Fresh downs for the Mountaineers. Garrison lines up behind Geno Smith.
Run.
He'll get the carry. Right up the middle he goes for maybe a yard. Nick Johnson, number 76, a defensive tackle with the tackle.
That's his second on this series. He's a JUCO transfer from Navarro College. He's the one who pursued on that screen earlier in the series. He's done a good job already today, keeping under control the West Virginia run game, which after the first couple of series has hit a bit of a wall in Nick Johnson.
No gain on that play. Second down 10. Smith in the pocket. Goes middle field. Up top. Six.
Play action pass, and then just one of the most accurate deep passers in the game gets it right on the chest of Stedman Bailey. Geno Smith showing why he's a Heisman frontrunner. Daniel Holgorsen is very upset. There was a personal foul on Stedman Bailey for spiking that football after he crossed the goal line. Dana Holgorsen's upset because he knows how important field position is in a game in which both offenses are going to go up and down the field. But the execution going back before the spike, what a tremendous deep throw by Geno Smith.
Then Kurt, the extra point. And that ties the game up at 21-all. What a ball game. Bailey over the shoulder catch. And the celebration. Oh, what a game in Morgantown on Fox. .655 to play, a shootout in Morgantown. 21-all. Baylor, West Virginia.
Geno Smith, 18 of 20 for 172 yards and two touchdowns. That's, ladies and gentlemen, why he's the Heisman frontrunner.
Well, that's his 20th career game now with two or more touchdown throws.
Came in 81% completion percentage. He's been fantastic today.
Has yet to throw an interception through nearly three games and a half. Kick at the 14-yard line. Goodley tripped up. And Baylor will start near their own 30-yard line.
No, there's not a lot of positivity around that Razorback program right now.
Back to work goes Baylor. 21-all tie in Morgantown. Glasgow Martin alongside Nick Florence. He'll get the call. He'll push the pile past the 35. Now Florence is a game manager, Joel. 8 of 11. Not quite the numbers that Geno's put up, but how about
that? He's been fantastic.
Yes.
You know, he's been tremendous in this game.
Remember, he had the pick early. And then he's been nearly perfect since. There's the pump. He's got man coverage up top on the run. Tevin Reese breaks the tackle. Touchdown.
Touchdown.
65 yards. Carl Joseph had Reese around the ankles, and Reese ran right out of it.
The wheel route from the slot coming out to the outside. And how about the speed of Tevin Reese? Baylor answers West Virginia with a strike of their own.
Extra point splits the uprights. Aaron Jones, 27th consecutive game with a reception, and it's a touchdown for Tevin Reese.
I mean, are you kidding me with this? These guys are awesome. Defenses in this ball game, my goodness.
Long kick, 2 yards deep. Here comes Austin. Makes a cut, 20. Watch out, 30. Austin, 40-yard line. Beautiful run. A dangerous run. He took it out of the end zone 2 yards deep and rumbles up to the 42.
Let's take a look back at that touchdown. Watch the defense get out of position. It's going to be a wheel route from the inside receiver. That's who the defender is supposed to cover. He's late getting there. The safety goes with the post route at the 50-yard line, and bang, off to the races. Tevin Reese ends up into the end zone. Nice strike by Nick Florence. It's easy to overthrow that ball. When he's that open, you got the look that you want to see. So credit the quarterback for stepping through and delivering that ball accurately.
West Virginia down 7. We'll start this drive at the 41-yard line. All day to throw. Tavon Austin flies across the middle of the field, and right on target is Geno Smith. These two quarterbacks are amazing, and you're talking about big yardage on
every snap.
This is per play now.
Every snap. It's unheard of. 8.3 yards per play? 7 yards per play?
Fresh down to the 45 of Baylor. Quick hitter, far side. On the hands of Bailey. He steps out of bounds at the 39-yard line. Sam Hall, safety with the tackle out of Katy, Texas. Catch your breath. Second down and 5. Make it 4. Big yards, 28-yard line. You know, both coaches told us they wanted to reestablish and work on their ground game. So far, critical times, we've been able to see a couple of nice runs to try to reestablish the ground.
That's what makes it so hard on the defense. You can't just spread yourself out to stop the high-powered outside offense. You also have to stay sound in on the interior.
Quick throw near side, J.D. Woods. He'll take a Baylor Bear with him to the 21-yard line. On him was K.J. Morton.
Petros, that's why I think the safety position is so important nowadays in college football, because they've got to be run defenders and great in the pass game as well.
And they can't over-pursue when they come outside to these hitch plays and bubble screens. Very interesting.
Jordan Thompson, late substitution for West Virginia. Bowie lines up alongside Geno Smith. Smith, protection, breaks down, throws it to the end zone. Touchdown! Stedman Bailey again.
Well, all you got to do is wait for your receiver to tell you, I'm open. Blown coverage by Baylor, and as Geno Smith was escaping the pocket to the right, Stedman Bailey does exactly the right thing and continue his route on the back line of the end zone. Perfect execution for the touchdown. And now the extra point.
Extra point is up and good. Bailey, what a day. A touchdown in the first part of this quarter for 47. He catches this one from 40, and we're tied at 28.
Watch Geno Smith just buy enough time. As the protection was breaking down, he buys time to the right, finds Stedman Bailey. Touchdown, Mountaineers.
4:54 to play. Now you have to just see it to believe it here. I mean, this crowd's worn out. They got plenty left in the tank, I guarantee you.
Right.
Not even halftime. And we're tied at 28 apiece.
We saw already now two different adjustments. Both defenses got a couple of stops adjusting. Baylor started bringing some pressure. West Virginia started bringing some pressure. And immediately the offenses counteract that with the bubble screens, the run game to the opposite side of the pressure. The cat and mouse game that continues to go on. This is the Big 12 Conference. This is what it's all about. It's not about total yards and scoring defense. It's about just getting those stops when they arise, and neither defense has done a great job of that.
Goodley tries to take it up the middle. He's met head on at the 25-yard line.
Led to their first touchdown.
This crowd revs back up. Baylor back to work at the 29-yard line. Seastrom tackled for no gain. And flying through, Carl Joseph, the true freshman, the free safety with a beautiful stop. In fact, Joe DeForest, the defensive coordinator, told us he may be the smartest freshman he's ever coached.
He's an athletic guy, and you saw a tackle in space. That's why they love him so much here.
One concern today, you've got to be able to play your lane, and you have to do open field, have open field tackling. Florence across the field, caught by Terrence Williams. And a first down, Baylor at the 48-yard line.
That's a matchup that they're going to have to exploit. Pat Miller's given a lot of cushion to Terrence Williams every single snap. And Baylor, even if it's to the far side, like on the last snap, they have got to exploit that in order to move the ball and gain first downs.
Five wide receivers set. Baylor again spreads the field. Florence in an empty backfield, and he is taken down as the Mountaineers come heavy on the rush. Doug Rigg with the tackle. He had the big play last week against Maryland, rumbled in from 51 with that fumble recovery. And Rigg has been active in this first half.
And he's normally a will linebacker, so they are rotating pass rushers. He's down there with his hand in the ground on the last play, trying to get as many fresh bodies as they can to get after the quarterback.
A loss of five, second down, 15. Florence up top, and a flag. There was a bump. Now multiple flags are out. Reese going one-on-one with the freshman, Carl Joseph.
Carl Cole Joseph.
Pass interference. Defense number 8. 15-yard penalty, automatic, first down.
Just lost his balance. That's what made him reach out and have to grab at Tevin Reese. Pretty clear call there for the officials, but I thought Baylor got fortunate. Nick Florence was under some pressure and threw that ball up a little bit. And just the stumble from the true freshman is what led to that penalty.
Last time Baylor was on the field, Tevin Reese was the big playmaker with 65 yards from Florence to make it 28-21, and then West Virginia comes right back. Fresh downs for Baylor after the flag at the 42-yard line of West Virginia. Hot slant down low, incomplete at the 35.
They ran a linebacker out of there late, right underneath the slant lane for Nick Florence. I thought that that was very confusing for him. That was Isaiah Bruce, the linebacker.
Another throw on the way, far side, through the hands of Sampson. And a hard hit, Pat Miller, you could hear those pads pop. And I think Sampson may have heard the footsteps. Ball is a little high and it stops the clock. 3:14 to play, third down 10.
Florence was asking for a face mask before he ever even went down to the turf. But West Virginia with the biggest defensive play so far for them of the day besides the
Spencer Roth at his own 35-yard line will punt away. Tavon Austin straight up. Good hang time. Fair catch, 13-yard line. Well, here's what's happened for West Virginia. Geno Smith, Joel, a terrific first half thus far. 22 of 24, 222 yards and 3 touchdowns. You mentioned those numbers are front runners for the Heisman.
Well, and he's got another series, so they will tack on to that. Then Bowie as a rushing leader. He's done a nice job. 9 for 42, over 4.5 per carry and the touchdown. And then on the outside, it's Stedman Bailey, who's been a heck of a target. 6 catches, 91 yards, already the 2 touchdown grabs. West Virginia now with another opportunity with 2:27 left.
Bailey now with 23 career touchdown receptions for West Virginia. Mountaineers go back to work. Bowie to the 17-yard line. And the clock runs now up on nearly 2 minutes left in this wild first half. Timeouts if needed. Baylor with 3. West Virginia 2. Over the middle, wide open. Austin makes a cut, near side, 50, 45, and is right out of bounds at the 38-yard line of Baylor.
Another blown coverage for Baylor. Austin, just an easy underneath route, and he was wide open. Geno Smith again buys some time, backs up in the pocket, and then you see the running ability after the catch of Tavon Austin.
45-yard pickup. Now the keeper, Geno Smith, smartly gets down on the grass, the turf at the 31.
Petros, he's just making great decisions. I mean, he hasn't made a bad decision, maybe one all day.
It's amazing. And this offense, I mean, both of these guys, it's exactly how these offensive mad scientists, Art Briles and Dana Holgorsen, would draw it up. Mike Leach is smiling somewhere.
Now, both coached with Leach. That's why they found this offense close. In fact, they'll give him a first down. Yes, Quentin Spain, the left tackle, nice seal block on that outside edge.
They coached with Mike Leach at Texas Tech in 2000, 2001, 2002. Dana stayed there for quite a while Art got the job at Houston.
Great catch, hip high on the hands of J.D. Woods. That's concentration, Joel. You're the old quarterback. You've got to appreciate that catch from J.D. Woods.
Yeah, there's no doubt. There are times during a game when a quarterback's only route is to throw the ball in a tough spot for the wide receiver. And you just ask your wide receivers, hey, a couple of different times, you're going to need to bail me out. And these guys do it for Geno Smith. That's the only way you can throw for over 80%. You got to be confident in all that. Yes, you got to be accurate. But you also have to have wide receivers that will step up and make tough catches. Geno Smith on the day, 24 or 26 for 273. Lots of great decisions, including using his feet to hurt the Baylor defense. They broke down in coverage a couple of times, speaking of Baylor. And Geno Smith, aware of what's going on the field, took advantage of those breakdowns. This was one of them, the second touchdown for Stedman Bailey. And how about Geno Smith? Most career TD passes for the active quarterbacks. Landry Jones, it seems like he's played for 8 years. Matt Barkley, same deal. And Geno Smith on that list. 71 touchdown passes in his career. What a phenomenal athlete and quarterback to be able to watch.
15 this season for Geno Smith, looking for more. Pedals back over the middle. Nice catch at the 5-yard line. Jordan Thompson, true freshman, Katy, Texas.
If you're open, Geno Smith will find you, and he's going to hit you in the chest. First and goal from the 5.
50 ticks. Now it's running on that first half clock here in Morgantown. Baylor shows blitz. Here they come. Cut back inside the 5. Still on his feet. He is buoy to the 2.
Hager.
Baylor calls timeout with 29 seconds remaining.
Check out of. Give the keys to the car to Geno Smith in this situation. Allow him to audible if he needs to.
Bowie and Clay in the backfield with Geno Smith. Quick throw, got man coverage up top. Touchdown, Bailey! Consecutive completions for Geno Smith. He hit 14 in a row earlier in this game, and this offensive show continues.
There's nothing to say. You cannot throw a fade better than that inside the 5-yard line.
Geno Smith, the 8th time in his career now, 4 touchdown throws. And we're not even through the first half. Extra point. Good. Bailey now with 3 touchdowns in this first half, 24 in his career. And that moves him past Cedric Thomas for most career touchdown catches in West Virginia history.
Well, he better watch out. His teammate is only 2 behind him. Tavon Austin is right behind him. They're going to be in the end zone quite a bit more through the course of this season. He's the prototype for the outside receiver. He's not very tall, Stedman Bailey. He's 5'10", but they say his wingspan is somewhere around 6'2", 6'3", which is perfect for that outside receiver. Big hands. And Petros, when you got a guy outside like Bailey and inside like Austin, it's perfect for Geno Smith. He can use the entire field.
Yeah, both these guys very confident, and they really do play with a lot of chemistry. Let me run this one by you, Joel. Geno Smith throws a masterful deep ball. I haven't seen a deep ball like that since Jeff Blake, the old ECU star, the greatest deep ball thrower of all time.
I'm applauding up here. I don't know if you can hear that. A Jeff Blake reference, that's tremendous.
Well, if you had to break down Geno's grade on his percent on completion, what would that be in the first half? He wanted 100%. He's near it. Stoneham with a return to the.
What's going to give down in Austin?
Baylor down 7. Florence, delay. Seastrunk could not escape the grasp of Josh Francis. That's what you call staying at home. Now the clock under 10. That could be the final play of this wild first half. Florence breaks out of the pocket. Little pitch out. Sampson. Oh my! Touchdown! This place was rocking. They thought Florence was down and then just threw it on the run. And that ball travels to the end zone with Lanier Sampson.
What's the fastest way to quiet down 60,000 people? I think Nick, I don't know if they could have overturned the other one.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. Touchdown.
So Florence had the foot planted. 33-yard line, the blue marker. You make a great point. It's not official, but it's just a line of reference. And the replay crew, led by David Ames, confirm it's a touchdown, 67 yards. And the PAT will tie this game at 35.
Unbelievable.
Picks up and good. 70-point half between Baylor and West Virginia. It's halftime in Morgantown. We take you back now for the Pizza Hut halftime report, and here's Patrick.